Hey everybody, welcome to Brother X. I am going to be doing something a little different. I'm going to show you how I make my pemmican. So first thing I do is I go to the store and buy a beef heart because they're fairly inexpensive and they have a lot more vitamins and minerals associated with the heart muscle. So first thing I do is take out the heart. There we go. Try not to have a heart on when you do this. That's get it all over yourself. So another thing is have a few bowls on the side. I'm going to sharpen a knife so we're not so we don't have dull knives, because dull knives will cut you. Sharp knives won't. So let's get some room here. Okay, so we're gonna just trim off all the fat. Trimming out the fat makes it a lot easier for the dehydrator or smoker to dry it out, a lot easier than having a fatty piece of meat. So we're just gonna give this a quick trim off all the fat. Sharper the knife, the easier it is. Okay. So here's a little more piece right here. Here we go. Okay, now let's trim the fat off of this one. And the fat on the heart is a lot harder than fat anywhere else. Just like the kidneys, it's almost like a suet fat. It's very, very hard. Yeah, I like the heart cut. It's tastes, I like it better than most cuts of beef for steaks and stuff. Like I said, you get a lot more nutrition. You get a lot more nutrition than just regular steak. You want to take your time and not rush anything and cut off your fingers or throw away good pieces of meat that you could have just salvaged by a little more patience. So take your time. It's not a race. Okay. Okay, that looks pretty good there too now. Okay. That's pretty thin, I'm okay with that. Cut. Okay. Now what we're going to do is cut this up in thinner pieces. I'm going to clean this up and I'll get right back to you on the next item for what to do for the homemade pemmican with using beef heart. So be right back. Alright, so now that we got everything tidied up a bit better, what I'm going to do is, now that I kind of section this off, I'm going to cut these into even strips, thin even strips. And you don't want it wedged, you want it pretty consistent. So. Take your time again, it's not a race. Knives are sharp, gotta be careful. I've been doing this for 2 years now, making pemmican. It's way healthier than buying any protein powder, period. This is the real protein powder. Okay. There we go. There we go. all the giblets and all the little pieces, we'll just fire on in. All right, now that we got a big bowl of heart, we're gonna marinate it now. So, allow me a moment to clean up and then I'll be right with you. All right, so this is how I'm going to marinate my heart here. I got a big bowl of beef heart. So I have a spicy shark from Pucker Butt. I like my pemmican spicy, so I'm running out. So I'm gonna put a touch of water and give it the Italian shake. So we're gonna get all the goodness out of that bottle. And then we're just gonna dump it right in here. Right here, let's clean it right up. Okay, so there you go. I gotta order more spicy shark. Next is Reaper Racha pepper sauce. So let's add a little water to it. Give it a shake. There we go. Aye, aye, aye. It thickened up at the top here, so. There we go, that's better. And get all that goodness out. Clean this one out too. Try not to touch your eyes. Okay, two down. I got the silencer. This stuff is 1.6 million Scovilles. Yeah, she's hot. Let's put a good dropper. I want to save some of this. I like this stuff on stuff, so I'm not going to use it all. I'll just use the full dropper. And then I got some DEFCON evil garlic sauce salt. I got a little bit left. Let's just dump that in there. And let's just go a little nuts here. I got some Reaper squeezins. Let's put some of that in here. And then let's throw a little Gator hot sauce in here. I really like Pucker Butt Farms products. Amazing. Go online, check it out. Okay, throw a little Gator in here. Okay, good. Now that's a hot sauce. Ooh, if I throw a pinch of my 1800 sauce, it's gonna make it taste like HP. Let's throw a pinch of each. Let's throw a pinch of that in here. There we go. Now let's give this a little whisk. As you can see, all that hot sauce is in here. Let's throw some Antarctic Pure Sea Salt with BC Kelp. Yeah. A pinch. Let's give that a stir. Ooh, I can feel my tummy getting all nice and warm already. So what I want to do is give this a little more water in it because it's got to coat this whole wok here. So I'm just going to put a little bit of water. Just to disperse the heat. Okay. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna start dredging each piece. Get a nice coat. And then just let it marinate. We do this with a whole lot. Might take a little bit of time, but at least you know it's going to be a nice even coat the whole way through. Yeah, my tummy is fire already just from that little bit of this stuff, the silencer. It's very strong. You got a nice coating. I'm sweating. I got a little sweat going on. Here, let's just do some TV magic. All right, now that this is all marinated, I'm just going to give it a wrap and give it a few minutes and just let it soak in its own in the hot sauce, just to get it absorbed for, I don't know, maybe an hour or so. Yeah, so we're gonna let that sit and then I will bring out the dehydrator and get her going. Stay tuned. All right, now it's been a few hours, not just one, since I marinated the heart for my pemmican here. So we're gonna start by just layering them up. So let's start placing these. It smells really good. Okay, and then we'll stack them. There we go. Fun, huh? So let's save some time. All right, I just filled up one entire dehydrator. Now I got another one I'm gonna do. So I'll just do a tray here. There's still cinnamon stuff from the last batch. I don't care if there's cinnamon on here, so just adds more to the flavor, I guess. And then pretty much the exact same as, yeah, so. All right, so now that I got these trays filled up, I'm just gonna put the last one up here, and I'm gonna put the lid on. Okay. We're going to just plug these in. One. And two. Now we'll just put them on and have them go overnight. And I will show you a finished result later. See you in a bit. Bye-bye. Okay, now that my heart has been dehydrating overnight, I'm going to I'm going to take all the dry bits now, and we're going to weigh them. So I just put them all on a plate. And that'll determine how much suet I use by the weight of the volume of the dry part here. Okay, so let's weigh this now. So this weighs 773 grams. So 773 grams. Then we take the suet and then weigh out close to the weight of the dried going to use it all. I'm not going to save a little bit. A little extra fat never hurt. Okay, so now put this aside. Turn that off. Let's grab all the bits of suet now. Okay, here we go. And then what I'll do is I'll start getting this we'll start turning this into powder. Thank you. see? It's a very fine powder now. That's what you want. Okay, so while I'm blending up all my meat here, I will transfer the suet into one of these. And then I'll keep my silencer, my Gator hot sauce, and my Reaper squeezins from Puckerbutt Farms, Pepper Company, Puckerbutt Pepper Company. I'll keep these aside, and then I'll turn on the stove. And get that rolling while I take care of the rest of my blended up heart here. So I'll just keep on doing this till this is done. Okay, so now that all this heart has been blended up, I'm just melting the suet now. Till it liquefies. And then as it liquefies, I'm going to throw some more hot stuff in here. Let's just empty the bottle. And then I'll put a little more Reaper squeezins. And then I'll do some more with some Gator hot sauce as well. There we go, that should do. And then we'll just give that a stir, blend that all up. Get the heat in there. So I got the heat in the dryness and I got heat in the fat. So we'll just give that a few minutes. All right, now that this is all melted, it's, as you can tell, see? So now I'm gonna take my dried heart now and then put it right into my suet. And I'm gonna start stirring. Grab the other one, start placing it in. There we go. And then start mixing it in the fat. And I'm gonna throw maybe a little pinch of my, just maybe a little more. And give that a stir. We could just turn this off now and then give this a good mix. There we go. Okay. I don't know where any trigger. Get this out of the way. Okay, so while this is still hot, what I do is I throw it on a silicone mold. Okay? And then you press it in the mold. And this is heart, so this is the best protein bites you'll ever make in your life. I put super hot stuff so no one else eats it, because they go fast. There you go, that's one done. Yeah, that's one done. Let me do the rest of it with magic. Okay, so this is what a whole cow heart gave me when I dehydrated it. I got two ice cube trays, and I got two silicone trays filled. This is extremely spicy, and it's awesome. This is the best pemmican that I make. I take this when I go ice swimming, or if I need an endorphin rush to help me get through the day. The hot sauce definitely helps me. It's more mental health than anything for the hot sauce. So, yeah, there we go. So now I'm just gonna throw it in the freezer for a little bit, and then I'll pop these out and throw them in a bag and show you how I package it. So I will see you in a few minutes. All right, so now that it's been an hour or so, everything should be frozen, so let me pull it out of the freezer. Okay, so here we go. Ta-da! Okay, so now we're gonna pop these out. And here they are. Little bites of heart with hot sauce and all that stuff, so. Just get that in there. And you can take four or five with you, and that should last you like a day's worth of food. And this is how I make my pemmican. go. Here, I'll... I don't know. I feel like it should be hotter. And there you go. And then if I want to go ice swimming or whatever, I pop in one of those to warm me up. And there you have it. Yeah, it's really good. I hope that helps you guys at home make healthy alternatives to just always buying stuff at the store. Yeah, this is tasty. Hope you like this video. Subscribe. I put a little effort into this. My editing and everything is not the best, but I try. It's better than doing nothing. It's better than wishing I did something and daydreaming. At least I'm physically doing this. May not be the best, but it's better than sitting around being a armchair quarterback, right? And thinking that, it's so easy to watch, but until you do it, you know, that's a whole nother story. So I encourage any of you, be a doer. Don't be a trier. All right, like and subscribe, bye-bye.